What's good, it's Cadillac Tracks, man. I'm back again. Hey, man, shout out to everybody that's on my channel, man. I really appreciate all the views and all the new subscribers to the channel. The channel's grown a lot, man, but that's really because of the quick tip series that I had going. It's quick tips 1 through 100. If you didn't know, you need to check that out. But you know, now I'm doing the live screen where I'm making the beats live, and you know, I apologize, these beats are kind of long, but you know, that's my workflow. It takes me a long time to put the things together, man. You might say that I'm working at a slow pace, or it might just be that, I don't know, I'm just slow as hell. But, man, kick back, man. Let's do this, man. I'm going to start off. I'm going to kind of let y'all know what I'm doing. And this time, I'm going to try to turn the mic off when I switch the sound card so it's not so many echoes. But, you know, just like every day, man, get some new drum kits. I got a few new drum kits here that I want to try out. Drum kits I got off of Reddit and some drum kits I got off of another place. And just add them to the collection. But before I do that, I need to make sure that I go through them so that they're not just lost in the sauce and never, ever, ever, ever used, ever. So, let's do it, man. I've been using this program right here, man, for a minute now, man. It's Chahulu. I used to like to use Machine, and on Machine, I would go to chord mode, you know, because I like the MIDI, the scale mode and the chord mode. So I used to get my Machine, and I go to scale mode. And I'd be playing a little scale, and then I go to chord mode, and I start playing chords. But, man, I noticed that after a while, that all chords sound the same, and I kind of, like, went through, and I used them all up. I burned them out, and I wanted to be able to add more chords, but Machine won't even let me add more chords. It's only got, like, a certain amount of chords in that little chord mode. And once you use them up, you might, you know, have to use them over and over. So I've been using Chahulu right here. And it's Chahulu's nice. It's a chord generator, but a lot of people don't like it because the chords, they're all old chords. It's got some presets, and it's got these old Bach chords, Bach chorale. I didn't even know what a Bach chorale was until I looked it up. But you know Bach, the old piano player like Beethoven and Bach. And he used to make these songs for churches called chorales. And they're like basically, Bach's music is real intricate. I started looking into it. I started to see that Bach, he can stack up four melodies at once. So he's got a bass line melody and a high melody and a middle melody and another melody going all at the same time. Somehow his fingers are playing four different melodies at one time. It sounds real good on the organ. But I've been using Chahulu, man. It's real nice. I like it, man. And but like I said, a lot of people don't like it because the chords are old dusty chords, you know, chords we don't really use nowadays, you know, like the chords Bach used in the 1800s and all that, they don't sound like the stuff we use nowadays, but I like it, man, so I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna run through it real quick. I'm gonna see if I can find some chords or a little chord progression. That's what I've been doing lately. I think I've been using this now for like maybe a month or two, and when I first got it, I was like, I need more chords, so I was able to get more chords, and I really just used the same few ones, but we're going to go through it real quick, man. So let's get to it, bro. I'm just over here chilling at the crib today, man. Now I woke up to two new purchases on my template today, man. So I want to give a shout out. Thank y'all for that. Appreciate that, man. Anybody that supported me, I appreciate that. The template, I hope it serves you well. If you have any questions or you're interested, let me know. All right, so let's start out with some chords, man. And I'm going to use Chahulu. It'll generate chords for us. You know, I usually get on my piano and I play on the piano and I go through sounds until I find a nice sound. And then I kind of make a chord in the scale of C minor that I'm used to. So let's just mess around real quick and see if we can make a chord progression. I got a piano the other day. It's called Mini Grand. Tried it out, it sound pretty good, man. All I have is a little keyboard right here, so I'm basically just using the Machine and the MK3 template that I sell. I just switched that sound card over, so you're just going to hear what's coming out the mic now until I get ready to switch it over for later for y'all. Just messing around on this. Looks like there's still some type of delay a little bit because I'm recording and I'm playing, so it's always a delay, but it's straight, man. I just gotta work around it so that I could show y'all the live screen. Alright, so put my machine template, turn that on. Chords to choose from, but I like these Bach chords, man. They're kind of interesting to me. I'm just gonna just go through them, man, until I find a chord that hits me, and then I'm gonna try to make a progression from there. That's not good. It's gonna sound like some old church music. Watch. So right now I'm using the MK3. You know, since I can play different chords with keys, I might as well use it. You know, play them on my pads. You know what I mean? Like I'm sampling or something. A lot of these chords are not really the way you would play them normally. You know what I mean? You can hear how he's like changing, but subtly. Not really what I'm looking for, but well, let's try a different one. I like ones that are a little bit darker. With Jahulu, I can make all the chords minor if I want. That sometimes that can help. Sometimes that'll mess it all up. Thank you. a different one. I'm trying to find some chords that represent me. Another thing people don't like about your Hulu is that the chords are not in any order, so I can't just play in sequence and have it go in order, or there's no scale, it's just random chords around the board. Go together, but fuck it. All right, so first thing we need to do is tap the tempo out, man. A lot of cats, you just start running with it. Man, at least tap the tempo out. Let me turn it on so y'all can hear this. I got a tempo button. All you got to do is or metro button. Just hit the metro button on my MK3 template. But let's just run with it, man. I'm gonna put 164, bro. Alright, let's record using the MK3 template. All we do is hit record on the MK3. Then we're gonna drop it from the top. The better one. I'm just gonna we're gonna select this one, right, with the little thingy, the green, and then I can push erase on my template and it'll erase the notes. So I'm gonna try it again real quick. Thank you. That's my chord progression. I don't have a fucking clue what chords those are. I don't know. So let's check it out, man. Because it's not like chord I would play. Like, so it's an E minor 6. So it's E, G, E minor, then G major. So it's E, G, E, B. And then again, E, G, E, B. And then it's got two more. Just another E minor 6, but it's completely different from that first one. So yeah, man, it's just basically a simple progression, E, G, E, B. That's how I know, or that's how I'll figure what scale I might play in when I hit my melodies. So it's up. This tempo's too fast or what? Maybe a little speed, right? Alright, yeah. Alright, so I like that right here. Do is I like that, and I'll use a piano to kind of reference the chord because it's time. So let's check it out. I'm really just running with it right now. Use my template, and I'm gonna come over here to my Nexus in content, and I'll just kind of browse for sounds using my template instead of my mouse. So I don't know, maybe something like a it's always good to have some pads, so try pads. You just start sending some pads over here to this Nexus, and we'll feed the Nexus into this chord progression. Turn the piano off. Alright, let's get a different. I don't know if that will happen. These are harps. I'm about to go fishing. These pads make me feel like the tempo should be slower. Crazy shit like that. I might have to do something with that. It's got a weird gate on it. Let's see. like it, but it's, man, I like it, but it's not what I'm looking for. I'm not really looking for art. Let me get past these arts and try some different pads out. Dark. I like that though. I don't think I want to use that one, but I did like that. Do with that, bro. It's kind of spacey. I might have to keep it under control, but it's just cool. Bring the tempo down. That better. It's at 150 right now. So this is one sound that I use, and then I start to layer it. I start to find more sound. At this point, I can use an art. You know what I'm saying? Like before, I was like, nah, no art. But that original sound, you know, didn't need it. Let me see if I can find an art. Something that's not so extreme that it just makes the whole beat without me doing nothing, but maybe just something a little pattern, you know. That's pretty tight. But it's going so fast. If I slowed it down, it might actually be nice. Let's see something. Fuck. It's really nice, man. So we gotta do something with that, man. Let me try to, I'm trying to put some gross beat on it because it's going like too fast. Like I'm in Nintendo land. It's gonna be nice when I slow it down. sound is doing a lot. Let me see what's up on this art. I don't know what about that. I like that though. It's kind of dope, man. All right, we're gonna add some sounds to this, yo. Nice piano, but it sucks. I have to find a better one. We need like a piano that so here I go. Maybe it take all that to load up. Alright, let's use the template and browse through the Nexus sounds. Nexus content pianos. You gotta be careful when you do that though. Some sounds don't load up, and they don't load up, they can freeze the program. So you don't want it to freeze up the program, you know what I'm saying? What is today's date? I need to be making more beats, bro. I think it's like the 14th or something. Thank you. it's like it's kind of moving. I like sounds like that that they have that moving effect to them. You know what I mean? All right, I'm gonna delete this one because I really wanted to put it on channel 18 right here. So I go to replace. Now that I got it there, I'll just you know, send it over there again. I like that, like that. Turn it down. Have a problem. Looks like my settings have changed to 316, 127, 14. It's because I'm trying to change the notes and shit. We still missing, though, the master piano. You know, I'm gonna dare do it, and I'm gonna open up. I said I was gonna open up Omnisphere Keyscape, but I don't even know if it's gonna give me justice. Well, let me try it out though. having a computer problem. It's the worst type of problems. That's a shame too. Alright, I'm back. Omnisphere crashed my Fruity Loops and all that, man. It made it made me just want to walk away from it, but I went ahead and loaded it back up, and just taking a long time to load up recently. But I went ahead and I got the Keyscape, you know, cinematic piano, and I put the chords on it, you know, and this is how they sound right here. It's kind of full, you know. It's got some reverb on it. Maybe I should put some more. Let me see how much reverb it's got. But yeah, I can mess with it too. So I was just saying it needs some bass notes with it. Like, I wish I had bass note following the chords at least. So I'm gonna put that on it, I think. By following the these notes right here. Yeah, like following some of these notes right here. Something like this, like these notes. You know, like, oh, I messed all this up, but it's gonna be something like this. Let me just copy these notes and bring them down here. Cause I want it, you know, to be another one of those. But I don't want all these notes. I just want like dun 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 dun. It was starting to get the static. I'm gonna bring it up a little bit just for now, though. Whoa, 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 whoa. Something. All right, I like that. I kind of like that. Something I want to do, just an experiment. I want to like have some reverse pianos. I kind of want to record this and see what it sounded like reverse, but no. So matter of fact, I want to do that. I'm gonna do it without the bass note. So yeah, let's just see what that sound like if I put it on this and I recorded it. Oops.
right, so we have this. How did I, oh, yeah, yeah. We got to get crazy with it. Hold up. This is some shit I learned on the Internet Money Channel. Whatever, reversing it, would they still play the same chord progression reversed? So, let me try that. Let me put these notes back that I had on there. And go ahead and take this piano and copy it here on pattern 2. And yeah, copy it on pattern 2 and then delete it and then put it on pattern 3 also. So I'm in control of it now. So let me just take these notes, flip them, right? Flip it, and then just put it in reverse. So it's in reverse, and then I'm gonna now that it's in reverse, I'm gonna record it and then reverse it. Hold up. Big dog, and then tripping. Let's reverse this. I think we can do it like all, and then the button, the direction button. There it is. So, and then also put this little bit of blur on it. Like I said, I got this on the Internet Money Channel. They did this. I was like, it's pretty nice. The blur kind of like mushes the sound together, so the little, we can make it a, if it wasn't all nice and fine, it could make it a little bit, like I said, it mushes it all together. So let's say if it was all, you had the offset off a little bit, it didn't sound right. If you blurred it, it would all just blur together. You wouldn't even be able to tell the off timing on a few of the sounds and blah blah blah. That's what I noticed with it, but before I do it, let me just play it again. Alright, just a little bit on this shit, man. I'm gonna, right, let me bring this in here real quick. Since it's in there, it's got that weird, I didn't even like that. I don't know what's up with that, yo. That, brought it in. It's gonna be right here. Let's bring it back in again though. I don't know what's in it. Just mess it up. Let me see. I just screw it all up. So we're gonna go to the piano roll and put it on pattern 2, which is. Thank you. show, so fuck it. Turn it off too. Crazy right there, so crazy little sound or whatever. All right, so we did that. I'm gonna roll with that. So got some pads, got the little ding-a-ding-a-ding in it, and it's got the bell, and it's got some piano. I think at this point all I can use is like maybe a flute or like some type of even harder lead, you know, something that cuts through. Like, let me see some. I gotta kind of pick whether or not I want to go reverse or piano at different parts. It's kind of a lot. It's kind of crazy right now, but. It's got this pad too right here. I don't even know how to really fit that pad in there. Yeah, like I was saying, something will cut through, like a flute or a high lead. These sounds are kind of all over the place right now, but let's go ahead and put the like I was saying, another sound on it. Let me save it before I try to open another plugin and ruin it. And like I said, I was looking for like a flute sound. That made me think of this one plugin I used to use. I could try it, but
just gotta. I'll show you.
Alright. It's this one right here that's ambient white. It used to sound real, real crazy, man. I think it was just this one right here. I think I just messed it up. Hold up. Kind of crazy. Put anything on it. Let me give my computer some room to breathe right now. It's got Nexus on it. I didn't know it was gonna receive notes like that. I guess I got it set up though to receive notes from the MIDI channel like that. This one's gonna work. Go back to the XLR. Just quit. Let's see. I just want to get these sounds off of the same damn channel. Thank you. key of E. I'm gonna put this on the E key on my template. Buffer back down like we were, like we had it. We can't play all these sounds though. The key of B. I'm gonna use the machine and pick a sound and try to do a little string pattern. And it's funny because, like, with the Bach, you know, like, they like strings and shit. So, kind of go with it. Sad ass shit right there. Let me just record a pattern real quick. Let me retry that starting from the beginning. Let me retry that again because I don't have the sound selected. Alright. Put it on a new pattern also. With the machine on the template. It's a good template, bro. Get that. Thank you. was record this violin real quick. Sad violin. I'm gonna put some port. I'm gonna use the pad, the effects pad strip. Put some portamento on it. Hold up. I'm gonna try it again like this. I like it like this, unquantized, raw like that. Let me try that again real quick. Like that, I gotta quantize this. I want to quantize the first one and this one. No, what am I doing? Yeah, and this one, and this one. Nah. I just want to quantize these two right here. Put some portamento with the strip real quick, like right here, mod wheel. It's already linked up. It's ready to go. I think so. Let me see. Go check on the mod wheel right here. I think it was linked up. Shit. But let's see. And then just gotta do something, man. I can't hear nothing. Thank you. simple violin and tweak it out, like, you know, gross beat it out with some stutters or something on it. Yeah, just like that. That was a harmonic chorus, and then like some just a gross beat, a random gross beat preset. Sometimes you gotta kind of look at it to see if it's doing way too much. It might not even be worth pushing play and listen to it. Just not do that and put this rotation on it. It's just the sound. I'm getting carried away with that one. But. And then I want like a high. I might even use a pluck, but I wanted a high piano, high notes. You know, like the twinkle. So like almost like a bell pluck, high piano. So I'm gonna try some plucks real quick. After that, we need to put just an intro. You know, I put my intro bass, and then just make a drum kit and go ahead and call it a wrap right here on this. And hold up. I want to use Dune. It's been taking a long time to load up. I'm gonna try it though real quick. I'm gonna make sure I save everything and. Alright, I got Dune open. Let's see if we'll find some plugs. Let me use my template and I got a Dune section I made. Plugs like that. 113 plugs. I don't know how many plugs. Be in this key. Let me try in the key of E again. Maybe I should try it. I don't know. E. I was gonna say E sharp. Maybe I should try F after that. B E B D. Let me try some other ones. Yeah. In the key of E right now. I was in B. What sound is this? 21. I got a knob on my template where I can just turn the volume down. It's kind of loud. If you got the template, you know what? When you push the, you know how it has track numbers. You know, the track, it has numbers for the volume. If you hold shift and you go to where it says show at the bottom bars, you can make it say values or bars. So if you have bars, it has a little bar right there to show you the volume. Anyway. Thank you. This isn't the sound I was looking for though, but I like that pattern and all. All right, let's see what's up. I like Doom, man. It's time to die. Hitting my space bar over here when I really should just be pushing play on machine. It's just a habit. But I just gotta record this, man. Let me just put this somewhere. I always do that. I just push record and I just jump right in. It on now, getting kind of annoying. All bring my thingy up again. So we got a little twinkle sound, and then I was saying It needed a, I was going to put a bass line on it, right? And, believe it or not, Nexus got some good little... Alright, so let me hurry up because I'm at 1:30 right now. Let's go over here with the template to the Nexus. I got the Nexus bass. It's just some the Nexus bass sounds that I organized into a folder. Use the jog wheel function, the secondary jog where I can go real fast. And start from like right here. Mustard bite. This is too much. And, I'm gonna go back to the B key, just like the melody, majority of the melody. Thank you. So got a bunch of sounds, and then last thing we're gonna do real quick before I end this video, it's already at an hour and a half. I'm gonna make a drum kit, and I'm gonna use some of the drums that I got, some of the new drums that I got, just like I was saying at the beginning of the video. So let's just go ahead and import those drum kits real quick, and I'm gonna go through them real quick. All right, I got the kits right here. One of them was called the Essential Drum Kit. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna check that out real quick. All right, here it is right here. Let's see what it's talking about. Now, at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna change the sound card over so that y'all can kind of hear the sounds a little bit better before we wrap this up here. And I'm gonna turn the mic off so there's not an echo like the last video I was doing here. I had another one. It's called the 4 a.m. Hallucinations Kit. I got a Just Chill Kit and a Lax New Kit. So we're going to go through all three of these. Also, it's a Goofy Sauce. I think all of these popped up on Reddit the other day, and I put them in my collection. So I want to go through and see if they actually had any sound.
Hey. Real.
All right, y'all, I've been here long enough. I basically put all these little melodies together, these sounds I'm going to use for the beat. I put a drum kit together, and now it needs to be sequenced out. You know, it needs a drum kit, it needs to be mixed. So I'm about to walk away from it for a minute here and go do some stuff, and I'm going to come back to it. So the next live stream is going to be me just putting this beat together. So I'm going to let you hear all the little bits and pieces that we got so far before we... You know, we got the drum kit that we just made right there. And let me just put my machine on. But yeah, we got the drum kit, and then we also got... All right, so we got a little drum kit, and then we got... We got some sounds for the melody that we have made. Remember, I think we got a lot of them. We got this bass line. Here, let's just play them. It's going to sound like a big mess. But we got to sequence it out here in a minute. that's about the gist of it, man.